But right now, let's go to New York and John Palmer.
Thank you, Dick. In the news this morning, in Shreveport, Louisiana, police are trying to keep the city calm after hundreds of people there rioted during the night. The crowd set fires and looted stores and held police at bay for a time, throwing rocks and bottles. Police say that the trouble began soon after a black man was shot and killed when a crowd that had gathered in the area turned violent. A fire truck set in to put out the fires was also attacked. It was several hours before those fires could finally be brought under control. In other news, in Frankfurt, West Germany, flight attendant Uli Derrickson returned to the witness stand this morning, reliving those terror-filled days for the court, those days in June of 1985, when terrorists hijacked a TWA plane to Beirut and killed an American Navy diver. Mike Betcher has more on the murder trial of the suspect, Mohammed Hamadi.
In his prison cell, Mohammed Hamadi appeared as a man unmoved by the serious charges against him. His demeanor has not changed in the courtroom during the damaging testimony. The hooded hijacker who did not speak during a press conference 3 years ago was the one that Uli Derrickson remembered as Mohammed Hamadi, the same man who she testified pistol-whipped U.S. Navy diver Robert Steedham before he was murdered. But Derrickson has stuck by her statement 3 years ago that she did not see who murdered Steedham.
Did you see the shooting or hear it?
I heard it.
Still in her testimony, Derrickson portrayed Hamadi as a man completely involved in the violence against the passengers. While trying to fight back tears, she recounted how Steedham behaved as the hijackers beat him before he was murdered. Mr. Steedham was a very courageous man, she said. He never made a sound. One judge asked her if she suffered psychological problems after the hijacking. My God, of course, she answered. It will never be the same. Mike Betcher, NBC News, Frankfurt.
Although Japanese Emperor Hirohito spent a restful night, the Japanese government today is making plans for the first succession to the chrysanthemum throne in 62 years. The emperor is in stable but critical condition at the Imperial Palace in Tokyo. During the night, hundreds of people gathered outside the palace praying for the man who was, prior to World War II, a god to them. Hirohito ascended to the throne in 1926 but renounced his divinity in 1946. Crown Prince Akihito is expected to take over his father's official duties tomorrow. In this country, consumer prices went up in August by 0.4%. Higher food prices led to much of the increase due largely to the summer-long drought. Michael Dukakis and George Bush will limit their campaigning today as they prepare for Sunday's televised debate. Last night in Bowling Green, Kentucky, Dukakis continued slamming away at Bush, accusing the vice president of hiding behind the flag. He then outlined a plan for national health insurance that would require all employers to offer basic coverage to workers and their dependents. Dukakis will announce his plan today for prenatal and infant care. Bush, meantime, accused Dukakis of dividing Americans by labeling Reagan economic policies as selfish. Visiting a flag manufacturing factory in New Jersey, Bush defended himself, saying that the purpose of economic growth is not selfishness. He urged prosperous Americans to have compassion for those less fortunate. Today, the vice president will take part in a mock debate in preparation for Sunday's confrontation with Dukakis. And at 29 minutes after the hour in New York, that's it from this desk. And now let's go one more time out to Colorado and Willard Scott.
Hey, good morning once again from the foothills of those glorious Rocky Mountains right here in Colorado Springs, Colorado. And the Junior League baked some beautiful cookies. They're having their big to-do. Starts the weekend of the 4th of November. Check it out. And a great cookbook, too. Let's also check out our weather conditions this morning and see what we have. We announced earlier and tell you once again, Helene, we have a brand new hurricane. It's brewing right now, even as we speak. It's about 1,500 miles out in the Atlantic. That's a good deal east of the Lesser Antilles. No threat to any land areas right now, but the winds are 85 miles an hour. It's moving west at 15, about 2 weeks away from the U.S. We will keep a weather eye. Look out also for some strong thunderstorms today. That means some heavy rain and also possibility of severe thunderstorms. That could be in eastern and central New Mexico, also the western Texas Panhandle and the southern and central plains. It is hot in the southern plains again today. Dallas-Fort Worth will be about 95 degrees. And also the Great Basin. Look out, the higher elevations getting some snow, just a touch of wintertime. There's still some fog in northern New England, especially Maine. Watch out for that. No delays reported this morning from any major airports. Here's what's happening in your world, even as we speak.
Wednesday, Bay Area weather calls for clearing skies, highs in the upper 60s to the low 80s, westerly winds this afternoon to 25 miles an hour.
San Francisco, California. That's our pick city of the day, 77 degrees. And Charlie Talbot of Clayton, New Mexico is 102 years old today, and I hope he watches this program. He has definitely gone for the gold. It's been a pleasure in Colorado Springs at the U.S. Olympic Training Center. It is a beautiful spot. Check it out someday. Now back to more Olympiads, and they're back over in Seoul, Korea with more action.